cloud. Okay. To make it more clear on this, I want to convert VPC to one company called Shoba Developers. Anyone know this company?
Yeah.
Who is that?
Principal.
Can you raise your voice?
Yeah, this is Principal.
To understand VPC, I'm using an simple example. So Shoba Developers, it's a company in Bangalore. So people who are in Bangalore, they may be aware of Shoba Developers. Or you can take anything, like let's take an example. We have DLF developers. It's an Indian real estate company, right? Let's take an example. These people have got a plots for sale. These people are putting list of plots for sale near international airport. Let's take Devanahalli International Airport, KIAL, Kempegowda International Airport. Let's take it's in Devanahalli. The people who are in Bangalore, they know this location. Yeah. So let me bring up my MS Paint. So whatever you could see here, this is airport area, government property, and this is Shoba Developers. Okay. As you know, for each and every plot, there would be dimensions. Do you agree?
Yes.
Right?
Yeah.
Okay. So there will be dimensions. So here, these dimensions are defined as subnets. So I'll just put it down. VPC means the total square feet area. Let's take an example. This VPC of total size is equal to 20,000 square feet. Okay, 20,000 square feet. In that, I have subnet 1,000. Again, another 1,000 square feet. Okay. I want you to define, or I want you to imagine like this. There is a total area where it is belongs to a private company called Shobha developers. So here I want you to compare the naming conventions like this. So Shobha developers, it's again. So Shobha developers is a private company who have total 20,000 square feet area, out of which he makes some plots, okay, plot 1, plot 2, plot 3, okay. Here I want you to compare like this. So plot 1 is equal to subnet 1. Plot 2 is equal to subnet 2. Okay, within this plot, what you will do, let's take Lavanya have one plot, that is subnet 1, and Manjunath have one plot. Let's take you are the owner of these two plots. What you will do once you purchase the land, guys?
Yeah, we have to first get registered.
Registered, okay, registration, everything done, you paid money, few white and few black, everyone is done, registration is done. Now what you will do, what's next?
So we have to plan for the construction if we are interested.
Awesome. Let's say you are interested, okay, and yeah, you're gonna, so that house is will be in the plot, right? So let's take, this is your house, and similarly the other plant owner also built his house. Okay, now this individual houses are called as virtual machines. What is that?
Virtual machine.
You're right. So it's called VM1. Call this VM2. Okay. Now you build a house. Around your house, what you will do? You build your house now. House is there. And you have your plot. Around your house, what you will do?
We'll do the fencing.
Fencing. Awesome. There is something called fencing. Fencing in technical terminology is called, in especially in networking terminology, is called firewall. Okay. So yeah, let's bring up the firewall. So firewall for your plot. This is fencing. Okay. Similarly, other user has built up its own firewall, and throughout your complete Shobha developer site, there is this guy, Shobha developers guy, has put on fencing. Okay, let me put it in this way. Throughout the Shobha developers 2000 square feet now, so entire 20,000 square feet, this fellow also put one firewall, security fencing. So let us name like this. So this one, and this one, as security. Just give me a minute, I'm getting a call from office. Okay. again. So there are two type of firewalls. One is at the subnet level. We call it as ACLs. Network access control list, and one firewall at the VM level. For a layman understanding, you just think like currently you have a security group. I'll brief it because there are two type of firewalls. Yeah, so now you have built your machine, and then you have put a protection. Now what you will do once you build your house, what you will do, Lavanya? Newly built house, what you will do?
We have to inaugurate it.
Awesome. Awesome. Yeah. So you're just printing an housewarming ceremony card and all. In that card, you're just mentioning something called root. Okay. The root is like, routing table is like root to house, root to your house. Okay. Now you have got your house, you invited people. Now in your house, you have to, let's take you are working from home. Okay.
Yeah.
So you're working from home. Now you need something to connect your office. What is it?
URA,
that is there on the security fine. Okay, let's take an example. That is gonna be your internet gateway. Okay, yeah. So you need to connect your office network, or you want to connect to internet. So at your home, you need something called internet gateway. So this is your site, and since you want to connect to office, you have enabled so you got a connection from Airtel or Jio, so that you can connect to internet and to your office network. Okay, so guys, this is a very simple diagram to make you understand the concept at AWS end. So is it clear for everyone, whatever I explain now on this diagram?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm hearing voice only from Soumya. Mr. Manjunath, Lavanya, Mr. Manjunath, Prasanjit, Prachwal.
Yes, understand.
Okay. Since you, I didn't give any plot to you on the site, you are not speaking, or what's your problem?
Silence can be understood as we are okay, we are fine, we are understood.
Okay, but for me, I need at least yes or no whenever I put some question. Okay.
Yeah, that's fine.
If it is a classroom, man, I can understand. If it is a remote session now, I should hear some voices at least from your end. Okay, now let's ask, who is the silent guy in our bunch? So I'll ask Prasanjit to brief this. Can you brief this for me? Hello. Oh, who else? So Prasanjit, when I asked him, he just left it. Okay, Prajwal.
Namaskar. It's like we have two areas and which we are connecting. Like,
VPC, raise your voice, man.
We have... Now can you hear me?
We can hear you. Yeah.
Hello.
Yeah. Go ahead.
Yeah. We have like it from scratch. Do you want, what are the things you told? You want to explain me about everything?
Everything from the scratch on this diagram.
Okay, sure. Like we have two areas. One is airport area, and the one like certain area belongs to Shopper developers, which has 20,000 square feet. In that, we have two subnets of 1,000 square feet, subnet one and subnet two, and we have the two plots, the subnets, we call it as plots. Mm-hmm. Then we have, they have built a house in it, that mm-hmm. VM2 and VM1 and VM2. Mm-hmm. And we have created a firewall, like we have a main firewall, which is created by the Shoreba developers. And mm-hmm. these guys have done a fencing for their plots mm-hmm. for subnet 1 and subnet 2. Mm-hmm. And we have a route table. To connect to it, we want the internet gateway, mm-hmm. like any service provider.
Mm-hmm. Okay, why you need an internet gateway
to connect it to the what? The other network.
Okay, let's take office network. She wanna connect to office.
Yeah, office network, yeah.
She has enabled it. Okay. Now, so this is a basic understanding, like how exactly your AWS VPC work, virtual private network works, virtual private cloud works. So I don't know why they have given a name like virtual private cloud. In my perspective, they should name it as virtual private network, okay, rather being mentioned it as virtual private cloud. Okay, so for your understanding, you can just think VPC is equal to a virtual network. Okay, within that network there are subnets, within the subnet there are virtual machines. Each and every virtual machine will have their own NIC card. Each and every NIC card will have their own private IP and public IP. Okay, are you getting my point?
Yeah.
Okay. So I want to you to, you know, remember all these naming conventions. The route table, you see here, no? Route table and NACL, internet gateway, subnet, VPC. So because I'm going to bring back all your learnings back to this image. If you understand this image, then it would be easy for you to understand at the AWS end. Okay. So let's do it. So let's get into my account. So we'll go to dashboard and so what I'll do, I'll just remove everything so that you can understand. Okay, just have a look now. Currently, I'm not running any virtual machines. Okay, and also I don't have any VPCs, virtual private cloud. So I have one. So what I'll do, I'll just remove off this, which I was used to for my testing machines. So let me remove off so that it will be easy for you to understand. So this is what the order I'm going to follow. There is a shortcut to learn VPC, or this is what the order you should follow. First, you should create a VPC. Then two, you create a subnet. Three, you point it to an availability zone. Four, you availability zone. Four, you can point it to your VPC subnet availability zone. And what else? Internet gateway. Five, route. So you just remember these five naming conventions. I'll brief you one by one. So just see now, first I'm gonna create VPC. So let me bring up this image. So private company, Sherpa Developers VPC, right? So I'm gonna give a name, name of the tag, Sherpa VNet, virtual network. This is my name of the VPC, VNet VPC, so that it will be easy for you. And can you see there is something called CIDR? Can you see this?
Yes.
Yeah.
So CIDR means classless inter-domain routing. Okay.
Sorry.
To make you to understand, I'll bring up this image again. See, if you take any property in the world, no, there are two type of properties. One is which property? Government property. Another one is
private.
Guys, private property, yeah. Right? So let's take government property is reserved. It is for government office purpose only, correct now? Example, yeah. Example, these are all like public IPs, reserved. And the second one is private property. And this can be used for public. And I want you to compare, I want you, this will be used for users, users, and I want to compare this with NACL IP or private subnets. Example, 192.168.0.0. N.0.0.0. Someone is cleaning the house. Can you just keep yourself mute?
Bhaskar, your voice is breaking actually.
Okay, I could see someone like Prajwal or somebody. There is a house cleaning is happening.
No, hot in my.
Who's that? Is that Prasanjit? Guys, you are in a session, guys. now are you able to hear me?
Yeah.
Okay. See, I want you to make a note of this IP ranges because we're going to use throughout our session. 16. So these IPs are called private IPs. This can be used within a company and which is not exposed to internet. Example, you can go and check your laptop IP. Let me show you my laptop IP. See, 192 series, 192.168. This is used on my laptop, but the IP which I shared on day one, like 122 series, do you remember? 122.x. Yes. That is a public IP which has got access to internet. So this is called a private IP which we will be using within this subnet. Okay, so I just want to copy this, and so you just remember these IPs, or I'll do one thing, I'll just put a snipping tool. We'll go back to my image. I'll keep it down here. Okay, so these are the IP ranges you're gonna use for your virtual machines which are running within this particular subnets. Okay, these are all called private IPs. Clear?
Okay.
And these IPs are not reserved. Okay, not reserved by government authority. Is that clear?
Yeah.
Okay. Yes.
Okay. Shubhankar.
Yes. Yes, Vasco.
I could hear some noise. I don't know. Manjunath, can you just mute yourself?
I'm muted. It was mute for me.
Then where is that sound is coming from? Okay, fine. So CIDR means classless inter-domain routing, which is usually defined between 16 to 28. And if you define this, can you see here 10.0.0.16? So let me bring up this. You can see here 10.0.0.16, and you can use any of these IPs. So these IPs are reserved for private usage, private IP usage. And I want you to compare this IPs with the site. Can you see here 20,000 square feet? No, VPC. So I'll put down here like this. CIDR Okay, you can compare like this. This is 65,536, whatever you see here now, that is called total number of IPs you can use within this virtual private cloud. So I want you to compare this IP address is equal to square feet. Okay, I told you like 20,000 square feet now. So in CIDR value, it is like 65,536 IPs you can create within one virtual private network. Is that clear?
Yes. Yes.
Okay, awesome. So I'm gonna define the same subnet. So I'll just copy this. So if I design, this is like a boundary, okay? I'm defining a boundary. Or let's say I'm purchasing my own network in cloud. I'm purchasing my own network that is consist of 65,536 IPs under this, okay? So now I'm the proud owner of 65,556 IPs. In layman understanding, Shobar developers purchased 20,000 square feet near that airport area, as simple as that. Now, what's next? What
subnet.
Is this?
Subnet.
Yeah, subnet. Okay, we'll see how to create a subnet. Once you created a VNet, we'll verify in VPC dashboard, it should show you your VPCs. So okay, now you can see one VPC, right? The same thing, I mean, when you click on your VPC, it's still the same. Now let's create a subnet. Okay, create a subnet. Creating a subnet is like purchasing a plot inside 20,000 square feet area. Okay, I'll give a name. Let's take Okay. And where are you going to get this? Under the VPC. So each and every VPC will have its own ID called VPC ID. And each and every subnet will have its own ID called subnet ID. So this is an ID for reference. Out of this 65,000 IPs, how many IPs you need for your plot? Now I'm defining. Can you see something called availability zone here? So this, yeah. I will brief it. Just remember this I'm going to brief in sometime. I'm just selecting one option. I could see two options, South 1A and South 1B. Okay. I've just selected. This you can forget because later I'll explain. So out of this 65,000 IPs, how many IPs you need? Now I'm defining the IPs. 10.0.0. /24, which means I need 251 IPs. Repeating again, if I mention 24, no, it will be like usable IPs will be like 251 IPs, total 256 IPs, out of which 251 IPs I can make use, which means what? I'll put it in the so my VPC total IPs 65,536. Okay, and my subnet one, this is gonna take 256 IPs. In this, usable is 251 IPs only. Okay, so usable IP, you just remember 251 IPs, and total IPs which you defined is 256. And how did you define? You pointed the same range, network range, but you change the subnet, you know, subnet masking now. So you changed it. So if you provide 24, right, it will reserve 256 IPs, right? Now I'll just click on create. You see subnet, I told you each and every subnet, there will be a subnet ID will be created. Yeah. You see, I created once. Can you see here one option?
Yes.
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah. 251 IP, and it created one route table. Can you see?
Yes.
A route table. It created one network ACL. NACL means what?
Network interface call. Oh, sorry, NACL is it?
Network access control list. Okay. A route table. See this, compare this naming conventions. See here. What is this? Route table. Can you see, okay, guys?
Yes.
You can see, yes. Route table. You can see NACL. So just say yes or no. And I have not defined any subnets. I have not defined any IPv6 subnet. So just IPv4 only. Okay. Is that clear?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. Now we'll come to availability zone. What is this availability zone? See, in production, you would have heard about something called clustering. Right?
Yeah.
What is the use of cluster?
Failover.
Awesome. Failover, load balancing, redundancy. We use primarily clustering for these naming conventions, these purpose, right? So let's take, you have a business called website hosting. Called website hosting, and you have a primary site. Name of the site is like this, flipkart.com. So what you will do, you will have two different locations. You will create site one in south 1A and site 2 south 1B. There are two availability zones, south 1A and south 1B, and main website name is flipkart.com. So what happens whenever customer try to hit flipkart.com, now it will hit to south1.com and then it will point to flipkart.com. Let's take suddenly this is down. So what will happen? You should have an alternate path to connect your site. So then automatically it will point it to site 2 and then it will point it to flipkart.com. As simple as this. Is that clear?
Yes.
Yeah, availability zones is used for load balancing, failover, redundancy purpose. If you want and business critical applications to be running in your environment, it is highly recommended to keep your virtual machines, multiple virtual machines in multiple availability zones. Okay, as simple as this. Clear?
Yes.
Okay, awesome. Now what I'll do, I am going to create a virtual machine. What I'll do?
Create virtual machine.
Awesome. I'll just go back. Now it's like this. You purchase, Shoba developer formed a site and you have purchased a site. Then what you will do? You're going to create your virtual machine now. So same thing here. I can click on launch instance. And I highly recommend please use Windows machine only, because many things we can try with Windows machines. Okay, now see, yesterday we blindly created our own machine. Do you agree?
Yes.
And we didn't mention any VPC, we didn't create any subnet, we didn't point any route, we didn't point any ACL, we didn't point any internet gateway. As simple as that, we just created blankly, right? So we could able to add it to that machine. Now we know what we are doing now. Okay, see, now this is called AMI. So I told you Amazon machine image, right? So this is what your Amazon provided AMI. There are two AMI, Amazon predefined AMI. Another one is you can customize and create it. So this is more like Amazon provided AMI. So we are making use of it. Number of instances, one. Yes, you're going to create one virtual machine. Site owner is asking, how many site you want, sir? I want only one site, sir, one plot. And where do you want? I want it in where? Where is this?
Shoba there.
Yeah, Shoba developers. Okay, and which is subnet?
Plot.
I mean, like where you going to build your house? So in your site, right? So Lavanya plot subnet one. Correct, and that will have like 251 IPs. Now, so do you want to have internet connection to your house?
Yes.
Enable, and then you scroll down, and rest of the stuffs are default. I'll explain to you when we have the directories and other stuff. So rest and all you can forget it. Okay, and the important stuff is interface card for your virtual machine. There should be interface card. No, the name of the interface card is ETH0. And storage for this virtual machine, you're defining an hard disk of size 30 GB. And add tags. Yeah, tags are like unique identifiers. Let's take tomorrow you have 20 plus virtual machines which you have kept in different availability zones, different VPCs, but you want to have a single billing from AWS. So tags will be helpful at the time of billing so that it can tag it together, or it's like stickering. You see, if you go to supermarket now, and there you can see they will give you a basket. In that basket, what you will do, you will drop all your goods. Finally, you will get it to one place for a single billing. Correct now? And yes. This goods which you have received will be in different racks. Some goods will be in groceries. Some goods will be in, you know, under some other racks. Some will be in fruits. you will put everything together and finally you give it for billing. Same thing here. This is primarily used for single billing tax. So I don't need it. Now, very important, there is something called security group. Okay, let me bring up this. Can you see somewhere called security group?
Firewall near.
Awesome. Firewall means what?
Fencing,
layman understanding, it's like fencing your plot, right? Same thing here. So here, you see fencing. As I told you, there are two types of security. I mean, security group. One is, can you see two colors here? Orange one provided by whom?
By the private company.
And this fencing, red color one, done by whom?
Owner of the plot, like VM.
Okay, see, either you can use an existing security group or you can create a new security group. So what you will do now, you create your own security group because the Shoba developers, he didn't put that much strong boundary. So let's take, you want to customize. This is since your house, you're putting extra security to your house. Let's take, you created a boundary and you put security camera and you have deployed one security man. So customize it, right? So create a new security group. I don't want to use my existing security group. Okay. So let's create one security group. So I have created my own security group. And this is key pair is like to enter to your house, you need key now. This is your key. Technology just launch instance. So now my instance is launching. So it will take at least 5 to 10 minutes. So I'm gonna pause the recording. Okay, hope you all can see my screen. So you can see this virtual machine is created, correct? Now, so now Lavanya can help me. Okay, just think like now you have built your house. What's next?
Bhaskar, can you enable that recording? Oh, okay, it is enabled.
Enabled, sir. Lavanya, now you built a brand new 1,000 square feet house. What you will do next?
I need to inaugurate it.
Awesome. So there is something called route table. Do you remember? Route table. That's what we'll do now. So route table will give you the direction about like how you can connect to internet. See, currently if I use this IP, right? See now, I just copied this IP. I would not be in a position to RDP to this IP. You see now, 13.233.127, the same public IP whichever is provided by the machine. See, RDP is failed. So what I should do is, there is something called a route table. Okay, route table. Let me switch to VPC. So this is the only drawback, you know, every time we should keep clicking on the tab and then switching it. Can you see route table here?
Yes.
So under this route table, you can see already there is one, our VPC has been assigned to a route table. I'll click on routes. Under this route table, what you should do is you should add a routing info. You should add a routing info like this. One moment. So under this route table, I'll tell you what to do. So what you have to do is you have to associate. You should say, if you are giving directions to your friend, you know, so you should tell, hey, you should take this main road and then come straight, take right, and then continue like 100 meters, take left, you'll find a house, right? Similarly, the route table, you should tell who is your source and who is your destination. Okay. So here you can see now I'm gonna edit the subnet association, which means I have to map your subnet to that site. It is like registering your site, I mean registering your or adding your house information on Google. Okay, this thing route table, it's like Google Maps, where you should give information about your location, house number and everything. So you see now what I did, I clicked on subnet associations and then I have, can you see, I have added this subnet under this route table for VPC. And now you have added and still you could not able to connect to RDP because you need to create an internet gateway. Okay. So let me bring up this internet gateway. See, for us, no, if we want to connect right from our laptop to the cloud machine, you need some kind of a bridge, correct? Now, like in this example, if she wants to connect to office network, she has enabled Airtel or Jio. That is acting as what? Can you see this naming convention?
Yes.
Internet gateway. Yeah. If we want to connect, this is a physical scenario, but we are built a machine on what? Cloud now. Since we have built a machine on cloud, we need a internet gateway to connect to internet world. So whatever the IP we use, it's all private IP. Do you agree with me? So where it is? Yeah. So these are all private IP. And we have got one public IP also because it is connected to and one default VPC. But if you want to connect to internet world, we need to have a gateway. So for that, we need internet gateway. So see now, we have to create one internet gateway. So I'll come back and you see here internet gateway.
Done. Yes.
So once you have done, then you finally you point that internet to this route. So now internet is done. Internet gateway is created to connect it to the internet world. So what I'll do, I'll go back to my VPC. I'll click on route table. Under this route, you click on edit and point that internet option which you have created now. So I don't see an option. So let me use a different browser. Never mind, it's got disconnected. I've connected back. Sharing my screen again. So it was not on my window. There is an option called adding an additional route for the internet gateway so that I could able to RDP to that network. So let me log into the AWS account. Round table. Select the route table. This route table already have internal information, internal communication information. Since I have created an internet gateway, this route table doesn't have connection to that internet gateway information. So what I'll do, I'll click on edit, add another route. What the hell? Okay, I don't see that option to available here. So what I'll do is I'll just remove this subnet association from this route table. I'll create a new route table and then I could add successfully. I'll create a new route table. Let's take Google Maps. Google Maps. Create. Okay, as you can see, can you hear me, guys?
Yes, Basco.
Okay, yes, awesome. Yes. Okay, yes, awesome. Yes, yes. See, I've created a new route table called Google Maps, and under this, I'll make sure my new route okay, I'll go to internet gateway. So here this was the thing. I should attach this internet gateway to my VPC. You see currently it is detached now. I should attach. Can you see this? Attach to VPC.
Yeah.
Select the VPC and then point your VPC. Click on attach. It's my bad. Okay. Come back to route tables. Come back to routes. Edit. Add another route. Can you see this? Select this and then point any IP which is requesting from anywhere in the world, that is 0. Means any IP in the world connected to this internet gateway. Okay, allow them access, allow them to connect. This is a route. Okay, can you see now internet gateway is allowed now, active now. Can you see this? Now I just need to do my subnet association. So to whom you should connect? It should connect to whom? My subnet, my site. So you're informing your friend, hey Geeta, when you're coming in Google Maps, make sure that you put this path and you come to my house. So you mentioned external road also, internal road also. That is all about a route. So now my machine is ready to RDP. So I'll go back to my EC2 dashboard. Running instance. can take my public IP. Can you see that now, guys, all of you?
Yes.
Yes.
So now I could, earlier it didn't allow me to connect. Do you agree?
Yeah.
Yes.
Fine. So now I just need credentials, no? So I'll just go back to EC2 and click on my running instance. Make sure I get a Windows password, choose a file, and point into my PEM key. And decrypt the password, got the password, copy that password, go to my sticky notes. And go back to the public IP, copy it. Click on connect. Administrator and sticky notes. Copy. Paste. Okay. Connect. Can you see, guys? I have successfully connected to my cloud machine by defining each and every parameters of myself. See, I mentioned all these parameters individually and I have connected to my cloud Windows 2016 machine. So loading the profile, it will take some time to show. Okay, it's loading up. And now I should also verify that internet is working on this machine or not. So click on this. Go to Internet Explorer. Type. Verify that. Awesome. So internet works successfully on my cloud machine. Fine. Okay. Guys, may I ask you individually to do this, whatever I did now?
Sure. Yes.
Yeah. You should do it and you have seen everything. So I'm pausing the recording. So let me know if you could see my screen. Hope you could see my screen.
Yeah, we can see.
Yeah.
Okay. So I'm into the cloud machine now. Just search some content. You should be able to browse it. And now we're going to do a very important thing. Once you logged into the cloud now, let's take it's like this. Lavanya friends have got into her housewarming ceremony, right? Once they are inside the house, what they will do?
They will
explore house. Yeah. Hey, where is the balcony and where is the hall, where is the dining hall, kitchen, guard room, right? Drawing room. So they'll explore, correct? Now, so
yes.
That's what people, they will test the door, hood also, whether it is fake wood, sandal. So let's take, this is like a testing type for us. So we're gonna test it. So in your cloud machine, you're gonna download an application called Bellarc Advisor. You just search this in your cloud machine, all of you. And you can go to that website and you can download it. Hope you all can hear me, right?
Yes, doing do.
Okay, okay, great. So there is one option called download a free copy of Bellarc Advisor. You can just click on this. It will allow to, it will ask us to download it. So you should download this. So prior to that, in Windows always there is a problem. So what you can do is you go to, see, just observe my screen, go to server manager. You have to disable this Internet Explorer enhanced security. So I need to server manager. Yeah. Can you see server manager? Just click on server manager. Once you are inside this local server, on your right hand side, you will see an option called IE, Internet Explorer Enhanced Security Configuration. Turn off this. Turn off. So turned off.
Sorry.
Yeah. So once you turned off, then you should able to download and run any application.
Sorry, can you please go through with the same?
Sure. Just go to search, type server manager. Can you see this?
Yeah, one second.
Are you with me?
Yes. Got
okay.
It.
Click on server manager and
yeah,
then
local server.
Then right hand side, you click on IE turn off. It will be on instead. You just turn off.
It's IE Exchange Security Configuration.
Yeah. Turn off. And then you download this tool, that is Bellarc Advisor, and install it. And also I highly recommend you to download and install Chrome, Google Chrome.
That IE Exchange should be on, right?
Off, turn off.
Okay.
Yeah. So I also recommend you to download and install Google Chrome so that you don't need to touch IE anymore. Install through Google Chrome on your machine.
Even user should be off or only administrator?
Default one, whatever is there, you just click off. So now I installed my Google Chrome. All of you just have a look into my screen. This is what you will do. Once you install Google Chrome, go to speedtest.net. So you're testing your cloud machine. How good my cloud machine is? What is my upload speed, download speed? What operating system running on it? You see the name, it shows Amazon. The vendor itself. It can be from anyone. It can be from, so it shows Mumbai. Mumbai Blaze Net. Go. Okay, just look into my screen. This is the super fast cloud machine which I have, which has got at least 250 Mbps as a download speed. And 450, so around 700 Mbps as upload speed. So look into my screen, 256 Mbps as a download speed and 747 as upload speed. I want to know what is your speed, all of you. And once you install this Balarak advisor, now you will see a report like this. Are you looking into my screen, all of you?
Yes.
Yes, yes.
Okay. Yeah, just have a look into my screen. So Balarak advisor is a PC audit tool. What is this PC audit? PC audit means whatever the applications, software, hardware, license info, it will pull out all the information from your machine. Okay, so let's take an example, computer name here and Windows version and which hardware it is using. You see, it is using Zen HVM. Usually in interview, they will ask you a question. Hey, what hypervisor does Amazon uses in the backend? So your answer is Zen HVM. Zen is from Citrix. Do you know Citrix, anyone?
Yes.
Yeah, VMware have ESXi. Similarly, Citrix have a virtualization software called Zen Server. So it uses Zen HVM. So to know more about this, just bringing up my browser, Zen HVM. So HVM time sets off.
Bhaskar.
Yeah.
Actually, I got stuck up while doing that installation of that Balarak. Actually, after that, what you have done with that speeder, I didn't get it. Can you please repeat it again?
Sure. Give me some time.
Yeah, thank you.
We did many things actually. You missed it, everything, is it? Okay.
No, while doing that, I for like.
No, that's okay. But what you should see, whenever I'm explaining, you should just see, right? See, installation, yeah. You don't need to do anything. Just click next, done. So see here. So I installed Google Chrome. Can you see this?
Yeah.
And then I went to speedtest.net. Can you see this? And yes. I clicked on go like this and it pulled out the information like what is my upload speed, download speed and everything. So see now.
Okay.
So it pulled up my upload download speed. I asked all of you to track your upload and download speed. And then that Balarak advisor report opened automatically next to my window. Now I'm just exploring this virtual machine. I mean, exploring my machine. So you see it is uses Zen hypervisor in the backend. And running with the data center version and it runs with Intel Xeon processors. Good news that Amazon free tier account, that too they are giving Intel Xeon. Usually it will be AMD most of the time. The machine which I got, it's Intel Xeon. So and what else? We could see license keys and all. I'll show you the license key for 2016. License. There we go. You can see the licenses. Can you see? This is a license key for Windows 2016 server. And there is no any application installed like MS Office, antivirus softwares, nothing will be there. It's just a blank machine and which runs with 2016 data center version. It runs with 1 GB of RAM, and by default we selected, you know, 30 GB of hard disk. It's like 32.21 GB. And these are the default applications which is running in the backend. All system related services. Okay, so can you please bring up two browser tabs like this?